Will Schultz from Okemos, Michigan. So I spoke last year, and it was the meeting last year, and the meeting has grown substantially in the last year. It's a good bunch of people. It's interesting to sit into the other departments. So this is, I'm on the veterinary side. We have the dentists that are here also. And it's neat to see what they're doing, because we do a lot of oral surgery too. But the different things that can be done with the laser are endless. So the meetings have been good. They've been focused meetings. We've had people from Europe at this conference this year. We've had people from out of the country. And it's interesting to see what they're doing and how, without cross-training, how the techniques are very, very similar from everybody. I am not a wavelength geek. So there are people that are. And so we know the nanometers, we know how long the wavelength is. But this is interesting because you're learning laser theory, and then you are dramatically better at setting your laser for delicate procedures versus a procedure where I can put it on a large spot or a smaller spot. I want to know what depth I'm doing. I want to know that oral mucosa is a highly fluid-filled tissue. The laser cuts dramatically better. You can use a lot less wattage when you're doing that. Some of these things are things you would not normally see in practice, and you wouldn't get from a veterinary-only meeting or a dental-only meeting. This meeting gives you a little bit more theory with it, which is mixed in with surgical procedures also.